few years ago now, I was lucky enough to be put into contact with Attila Pink of Catch Carp Hungary. Attila has access and runs the bookings to some fabulous waters in Hungary, and I've been lucky enough to fish a couple of those already. The first one we went to was Paradise Lake, which was absolutely brilliant, both of us catching fish over 20 kilos on that trip, amongst a great many others. It was action from start to finish and brilliant. But the year after, we was also lucky enough to be able to fish the famous Lake Balaton, Europe's biggest natural lake, and it was absolutely fantastic. It was on my bucket list to fish that lake for so many years, and through Attila I finally got to do it. But for this trip, we were going to the much smaller but very prolific Island Lake. Well, we've just arrived at Island Lake, flew over into Budapest, and Attila's picked us up and brought us here, and it looks absolutely lovely. This is our swim number 15. Got a little bucket of bait just been dropped off, and as usual, the package is really good. Engine, battery, boat and swim all ready. And this is our cabin. Looks absolutely fantastic. Really, really nice. It's going to be nice being in here. But there's a ton of gear all over the place. And we've been to the shops first, bought some food, got some water. Attila's, he provides all the gear for the main people flying out. We've got pursuit rods here, 12-foot 3-pounders, pods, and that's all the stuff that I've flown out with, my reels, terminal tackle. Yeah, a lot of gear to sort out. First day's always a tough one. Not too bad flying out, saves all that long journey what we normally have driving. But well, we was at a wedding yesterday, so it was a late night last night, early morning this morning, and a little bit tired. But yeah, sight for sore eyes that is. Looks lovely out there. A lot of big carp out there. Plenty over 20 kilos, up to just over 30 kilos apparently. So yeah, looking good, looks good. Right, a lot of work to do, a lot of rods to get sorted out, and various bits and pieces, so yeah, let's get started. We'd been warned that storms were forecast, and it didn't take long for the first one to arrive. It wasn't actually a bad thing, because it certainly got the fish feeding. Despite the bad weather, as usual, it didn't stop me trying to get the rods back out. Right, there we go, we're off the mark anyway. Really good night, really stormy night, perfect carp conditions, and this is quite a pressured lake, you know, the areas get fished all the time, so I thought I'd try and change things up a little bit. I had one with a pop-up, one with a wafter, one with a snowman, and actually all three of them went off, so this was on the wafter. All 30-pound commons. This one was 32, another 32-pounder, and one 34, so yeah, there we go. Things are working anyway. And that's it, we're off the mark. It's always nice to get started. Yeah. And a pick of the bunch, 34 pound. There we go, Joan's first Island Lake carp, 21 pound. Literally just doing a bit of video and off it went.
Fader.
God, what a scrapper, yeah, and it's still not giving up, is it? Nice though, off the mark, both off the mark.
Okay.
couldn't really film getting the rods out yesterday evening because it was a bit stormy. Very stormy, in fact. But it's a lovely day today. So here we go, just replacing one. Attila said a lot of the guys actually put their baits round the back of, just tucked round the back of the island. I mean, the island sort of formed the boundary. In between those islands is like a safe haven for the fish, you know, so you're not allowed to fish actually in the channel, but you can just go to the outer edge of the island. What I found out here is some really nice hard areas. A lot of the bottom's quite soft, soft and silty, but in amongst it all there are some really nice hard areas, and one of them's just in front of this channel here, and it's done a couple of bites already. The best way to find these harder areas is with the prodding stick. It's not very deep here. Is it about 4 or 5 foot? Yeah, see, it's just a little bit on the soft side there. Yeah, you can actually hear that clonking on the bottom. See, and yeah, I'm just going in with what I've used a lot actually in different places. 18mm citrus wafter over some scopex squid. As I've already had a couple of bites on this one, I'm going to put a bit more bait around this one. Plus, as I've got this other team next door now, right, there's this particle mix which is sort of sold on site. It's a weird sort of peas, bit of maize and all that, but seems to work anyway. Bit of pellet. Another nice day in Hungary today anyway. It's a bit windy as it goes, it's blowing a bit of a hoolie out there, but it's still quite warm. It was a quiet night actually for me last night. After a bit of action the night before in the storm, this wind seems to have moved them around a bit, and swim 11, which is sort of right up the end there, they did well last night. Apparently 6 fish, I think one of them was a sturgeon, but they still had, I think, 5 carp just over 40 pounds. So seems a bit like that, you know, the fish move around. Plus, I had another, I think, 4 teams arrived yesterday down to my left, where a lot of the fish were showing. So the extra lines and all that seems to have pushed them away. But, you know, that's how it is on pressured lakes. As soon as there's an area free of lines, the fish move into it. And of course, as soon as those lines go back in the water, it moves them again. So it's going to be a bit like that. For that reason, I'm actually going to put back leads on. I started off with 3 rods out and different rig on all of them, a pop-up, a wafter and a snowman, and actually all 3 of them went off, but it seems to be the wafter that's come out on top. We've now had 3 takes on the wafter. The others haven't gone off again, so it's quite strange that all the waters I've fished over the last, well, probably 6 months, going back to Christmas even, at Secret Garden in Croatia at Szumbar and Goslowica in Poland, the winning method each time has been a citrus wafter over scopex squid bottom bait. The rig is the same as it ever is, but I do get asked, you know, what rigs I'm using. So, you know, it is a size 6 claw KD style to 15 pound skin leap, with a little bit of silicon tubing just over the eye. You know, like I say, it's a simple rig. It's more or less the one I use all the time. But it is the one that's working yet again. And that's an 18mm white citrus wafter. As long as something works, that's all that matters really, isn't it? As long as you can find something that works. What I've caught already has been nice, but it'd be nice to get one of those 40s, 50s. I mean, they go up to 30 kilos, so that'd be good. But Yeah, just a few fish would be nice, wouldn't it? We'll see. Every session on every lake is always different, and it takes a few days perhaps to get the tactics sorted and the baiting situations right, but me and Attila were starting to get it all together. The fish weren't round the island so much as we thought they would be in the first place, and it was that mid-water region that was really producing the goods. We started to fish as a team, baiting up the mid-water region, and as we did that, the action started to pick up and also the average size of the fish started to go up as well.
Well, just baited the area, I put out the rod, and literally in 20 minutes my left one was off with this still very, very lively, beautiful common. Check it out. The sun just went down, it's about 9 o'clock. I took out my rods, I refreshed them, started around 8, and here it is, the result. Again, the citrus wafter was the winner. That works really well on this lake.
God, I still fight like crazy. There we go. I don't know how big. Maybe 15 pound or something. Good little scrapper anyway. You can go straight back though. Thank you, little fella. Good fight, but go and get your mum and dad. God, it's been such a stormy day today. Forecast strong winds today, and well, we certainly got them.
but it seems to have turned the fish on anyway. Seen people catching all round the lake, and this is number 5 today, and the best one so far, just over 36, about 36 and a quarter. And again, it come on like the mid-range rod. You know, with all those islands down the middle, it's so tempting to put rods out to them around the margins and on the ends. But as often happens, the best fish, the biggest fish, are just coming from mid-water, sort of halfway out. And so, yeah, the best two fish today have both been on that rod. We're sort of getting things together now. The weather's really doing us a favour. It's hard work, but it's perfect fishing weather at the moment. So, at the days, I think we've got another day of this tomorrow. So, hopefully a few more things like this. Wow, that's certainly what you call a storm cloud. Blimey, looks like an atom bomb's gone off over there. Fifteens and twenties. Well, target achieved. My hope for this trip was to get one over £40, really. So, I know there's bigger ones in here, but realistically, I thought if I can get a 40, it'd be a great trip. And I say that about most waters, and there we go, 41 and a quarter. Oh, two in the night. This one and a 24 and a half. I feel like he's tempting, he's going to go mad any minute. But yeah, well pleased with this. All commons. I mean, the tiller had a mirror yesterday. All I can catch is commons, but not complaining when they're like this. I've actually moved this rod yesterday afternoon. It's my left hand rod, the closest in one, and it was the first rod that produced, but it had been quiet after that. It produced a nice 34 first night, but then it went quiet. So yesterday I moved it further out, about another 40 yards further out, and still only about halfway out to the islands, that sort of mid-water area again. Little citrus wafter, another scoped squid, and yeah, this was the result. So yeah, very, very happy, and still a couple of nights left, but yeah, this is what I wanted, a 40 pounder, so yeah, well happy with this one, really, really pleased.
We were all having a great time at the Island Lake. It was great fun and the fishing was fantastic. We all agreed that the carp were some of the hardest scrappers that we've ever come across anywhere. But it was all brilliant stuff. Of course there were quiet times through the day or the night when the fish weren't feeding. But that was when we had a chance to relax a little bit, because when the fish did come on the feed, it was quite hectic for both of us. And we was running between swims, photographing fish, weighing fish, and sort of congratulating each other on their successive catches. It was really good. The fish were getting bigger, the action was coming more frequent, and we were getting it all together. What a fantastic surprise. They've been getting bigger gradually every day, from 30s into 40s, and now this absolute cracker of 46 pound. And when I hooked it, it felt small, and even playing it, even going into the net, I thought, that's only a small one, until I went to lift it out. And yeah, there it was, 46 pound. What an absolute beauty. Oh, all been caught, I still haven't caught a mirror, but who cares when they look like this? Fantastic. Oh, right, that'll do. They always say that time flies when you're having fun, and before we knew it, the last morning was upon us. It had been a fun-filled, action-packed week for sure, and we had all had a really great time. The final morning was lovely and sunny, and we was looking ahead to the chore of packing up and getting everything sorted, but the lake had other ideas. It still had a few surprises in store for us.
Look at the guys, this fella. My wish just came through, because on my last day, this is our seventh day, I could manage to catch this lovely common just above, just over 20 kilo, 20.1, so just over 44 pound. You know, Steve had one already earlier this week, and this was my goal. I wanted to catch a carp above 20 kilo, and here she is. A lovely one. Where we were just taking pictures of the lovely 20 kilo one when one of my rods went off, and 10 minutes later, this is the result. Look at this angry fella. So, my last day, it's really great. Last day morning, we're about to pack, and one 20 kilo, one almost 18 kilo fish. Awesome.
Well, one last fish and another nice one, 38 and a half pound, another common. Actually managed to get a mirror through the entire trip, all commons, but loads of lovely ones like this. Actually had two this morning, the smaller one about 25 pound, and this one that really tried to pull my arms off, the hardest fighter of the lot actually. Whew. And it Still hasn't given up yet. I still feel it tensing up, so it might go bananas in a minute. But yeah, lovely way to end. Fantastic week. It's been brilliant here at Island Lake, so thanks very much to Attila. And you know, we've had a fantastic time. It's been a really good week and a really nice venue, and we've had loads of lovely fish like this. So it's all over now. Fish have actually started spawning this morning, so it's not a bad time to pack up and head for home once again. So that's it for this time. See you next time.